Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are gonna talk about standard practice for making concrete according to ASTM C192. The first step is to gather all the material we need. This includes cement, fine aggregate, which is smaller than 5 mm, coarse aggregate, which should be in a mixed proportion based on ASTM C133. To achieve this, we will perform a sieve analysis for each size of aggregate and draw a curve for different proportion and find the best curve that is within the limits of the standard. Lastly, we will need water. And guys, be sure you have the right amount of each ingredient according to the specific mix design you are using. Alright, now it's time to mix our concrete. But before we add all our ingredients inside the mixer, let's add a little bit of water to the mixer. And this will make sure that we don't lose any mixing water during our mixing time. And after that, we should remove the excess water from the mixer. Okay, now let's start our mixing. For mixing part, I will add all size of the coarse aggregate inside the mixer and let it mix for like 1 minute. And after that, I will add a proper amount of water to the coarse aggregate. And this will ensure that the coarse aggregate is reached to the wet condition. Then I will add the fine aggregate in 3 or 2 portions. And meanwhile, I slowly add the water. It will help you to reach a homogeneous concrete at the end. After you add all the ingredient and water inside the mixer and it mixed properly, it's time to add the cement. But it's the same manner as we add fine aggregate, so do it very slowly and meanwhile check the water, and if it needs more water, put more water inside the mixer. Don't pour all the water into the mixer and keep some of it. Here's a tip. Use the slump test to check the workability of your mix. If the slump is within your desired range, we are good to go. If not, add more water and check it again. Remember that the water-cement ratio is crucial for the strength and durability of your concrete. After adding all the ingredients, we will mix the concrete for 3 minutes. Then stop the mixer for 3 minutes and let the concrete rest, and follow that by another 2 minutes for the final mixing. It's important to follow the ASTM C192 mixing time to ensure that all ingredients are well combined and the concrete is homogeneous. For the slump test, prepare the slump cone and place it on a flat, non-absorptive surface. After that, prepare your ready-mixed concrete and fill the cone in 3 equal layers. And remember, each layer should be tamped 25 times with a 16 mm steel rod. Make sure when you want to tamp the upper layer, your rod shouldn't penetrate into the lower layer more than 1 inch, which is 25 millimeters. After the last layer is roded, the top of the concrete should be struck off level with the top of the cone. And then carefully lift the cone straight upward without twisting it. And measure the slump of the concrete by measuring the distance between the top of the concrete and the top of the slump cone. And this will give you the slump value. Once the concrete is mixed, I will cast it into the mold for testing. I will ensure that the mold are properly oiled and the surface of the concrete specimens are smooth and level. And that's it, guys, for today's video. I hope you learned something new about mixing concrete with following ASTM standards. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. See you in the next one.